this who you were expecting to see? Is this whose channel that you clicked on to watch? About to put on deodorant. Deodorant morning. Also got this from Urban Outfitters, this pistachio brulee perfume, and I haven't stopped wearing it. Smells so good to me. It got vulnerable last week at the end of last week's vlog, going to act like that didn't happen. As soon as I get vulnerable, I just control delete that from my brain. Hey, I never got vulnerable. Hey, yes, it's true, but I'm not going to be speaking about it. So I am feeling, I don't even know what I'm feeling lately. Feel like, am I probably on the urge of a huge breakdown? Absolutely. I'm like, nothing good can be coming out of this. Gonna use this claw clip. Anyway, but I have quite a bit on the schedule, and literally all that I want to do is play Animal Crossing. Hey, I've been back into my Animal Crossing phase. So I watched Sinjin Drowning. I feel like I've talked about it. Weston and Kaylin Corey, love them. I've loved them for years, and one of my comfort videos, and honestly you can tell that my mental health is declining, is I will either put on like old Cody Ko, old Emma Chamberlain, and I'm talking like beginning of channel Emma Chamberlain all the way up until she moved to LA. Like it's that. I'm trying to think of what else. Old Alicia Marie. If you see me throw on some 2014, 2015 old Alicia Marie vlogs, send help. But another one is the Sinjin Drowning Animal Crossing. And so I started like putting that back on again to sleep, because I needed, like, right now I'm not in my comfort show, I'm in my comfort YouTube video era. So I started putting that on to sleep. And then, of course, it brings on the other Animal Crossing YouTubers that, like, I watch when I'm in my Animal Crossing mode. Now, all I want to do, I don't want to do anything except play Animal Crossing. I don't want to pick up the camera. I do want to read. I spent the whole entire weekend reading. I read 4 books. I need to finish 2 other ones so I can start editing that video, which is really what's on the agenda for today. I'm in my Animal Crossing era, and I've decided, oh my god, this is so niche. If you guys don't play Animal Crossing, you guys literally won't know what I'm saying, but I restarted my island. I had like a fall themed island that I never finished from a few months ago when I was deep into my Animal Crossing era. So now with summer coming up, I've decided to do like a summer European island, and I am in the beginning stages of like the, like, I don't even have like town hall yet. I just got the museum. Nook's Cranny is like still in the first stages of its tour. It's bringing me back to my senior year of high school when I would literally wake up early. I would wake up at 5 a.m. go to the gym, and keep in mind, I think school started at 8:45 for me, so I would go to the gym at 5 a.m. I think I would get home around like 6 something, and I would get ready for the day, and I would do it so I had like an hour and 30 minutes I could sit and play Animal Crossing before school. And honestly, it was a way of like, I was so anxious to even think about going to school, so I would do that so I could kind of decompress before I went to school, because Animal Crossing has always been kind of an anxiety reliever for me. I'm so focused on what I'm doing that I'm literally never thinking about anything else. So that's why I keep coming back to it. I can't believe I'm ranting about Animal Crossing right now. So to help with some of that, what I've been doing is I've been listening to audiobooks as I'm playing Animal Crossing. Like, I'm filming it, the video's already out. It's the reading the new releases, because there was like a whole lot of new releases that came out at one time, like Magnolia Parks, If Only I Had Told Her, Bride, Good Materials, The Breakup Tour, I think are the ones that I read in that video. And so I read those and I listened to Good Materials. Literally, I listened to that entire audiobook and sat in my bed and played Animal Crossing, and it is a cheat code for me. Like, when I don't feel like reading, but know that I probably should be getting reading done, or I do feel like reading, but I really want to play Animal Crossing, hey, pop on an audiobook and literally leave me be. Literally leave me there. I don't care to do that. That's been like a new development over the weekend. The whole entire weekend, I literally did nothing except read. I just got back from the gym. It's a Monday. I'm like, hey, it's Monday. Hey, I know, like, me editing that I put the day, but I feel weird that I like haven't said it yet. It's a work day. We have a whole lot of work that needs to be done. So at some point through the week, I would love to clean my room. It's like, well, right now, honestly, I just have like a few clothing items I need to pick up. I need to put laundry away, just pick up a few things, like reorganize, because I feel like I was doing so good in January, but I feel like the two correlate. In February is where my mental health has really like taken a nosedive. It like was standing on the edge of a cliff and then it jumped off. And so right now we're like in the water of that. So I feel like the first thing that goes down the drain is my room, always, of course, because I feel like the space that you spend the most time in, which is my room, is kind of a mental reflection of you. And I feel like is a reflection of you, like even the way you like decorate your room and the stuff you put up. Like, I feel like your room is one of the most intimate places, because I feel like it is kind of a show of your mind in a way. Like, If somebody walked into my room, they could learn everything about me. So it makes sense that the first place that you can tell signs of mental deterioration are within my room. So at some point this week, I would like to clean that up. I just got hit with a wave of tiredness. I actually didn't really drink my Alani this morning, and then I came home and immediately poured it down the drain. Don't know why I did that. I literally just like walked in the door, walked to the sink and poured it down the drain, but I'm taking it as a sign. So I think I may make a coffee. Okay, glad we had that chat. Do you guys know what needs to be studied? The phenomenon of after Adele released Hello, that the fact that I want to start every single clip of anything that I've ever done by saying, "Hello, it's me." Anywho, it is Tuesday. I just got done editing my reading new releases. Thank God I never want to see that video again for some unbeknownst reason, except I do know it. I hate that video. I just feel like it's a crappy video. I've been feeling like that with everything that I put out lately, and I don't know if it's because I'm genuinely not producing quality content or I am just a hater of myself. But to keep you guys up to date, yesterday I basically, after I filmed the random clip that I did yesterday, I read for the rest of the day and edited. Like, I just worked all day, and then I woke up this morning and still wasn't done with the video. So I went to the gym, and then me and my mom actually went out for breakfast, and I went to Sephora, which I'll tell you guys here in a sec. And then I came home and I finished editing so I can get this video sent over to my manager, because I know that she's probably thinking in her brain, "Hi Veronica, if you're watching." I know she's probably like, "Destiny, where is this video at?" And I'm like, "Listen, I hate this video. I never want to see this video again. Just please take it from me." So as I alluded to for a second ago, I did go to Sephora. I haven't been to Sephora in I don't know how long. It's been a while since I've been, because I have been in a huge depressive state where I have literally not even left the house. When I asked my mom, I was like, "Yeah, I like have been needing to go to Sephora. So like, do you want to go to breakfast in the morning? And then I'll like stop by Sephora," since it's literally right next to the Sephora. My mom was like, "Wow, like I have not even been able to get you like out of the house for anything that like you don't have to do. Like, you have not even been leaving your room." Yeah, well, it's kind of getting to the point where like I need this stuff, and that is quite literally like the only reason I'm even getting out to go anywhere. It's bad. I'm laughing, but it's not funny. So I just had happened to run out of shampoo and conditioner, all of my body lotion, moisturizer, face wash. What else? I'm running low on body wash. Was running low on like just a bunch of different things. And then of course, once I get into Sephora, I start seeing other things and I'm like, I want to buy that as well. We have an interesting haul for you guys. So starting off with really what finally pushed me to be like, yeah, I just need to like go and get the restocks, was that I needed new shampoo and conditioner. And lately I just feel like my hair has been getting so oily so fast. I feel like it's like being dull. I like had seen on TikTok, oh my God, what a sentence, right? Because it's literally what we use for credibility. Somebody had said like, or I'd seen it multiple times like throughout my life, that if your hair is kind of getting oily quicker or if it's kind of dull, you need to switch up your shampoo and conditioner. And I've seen multiple times like you need to switch up your shampoo and conditioner. I don't know why. I thought like, if it's not broken, don't fix it. Guess that doesn't apply to shampoo and conditioner. I've been using the Briogeo for like a year and a half now. I've been just a ride or die, tried and true. Haven't changed it. Why change it? I know that you should not use sulfates. Like, you shouldn't use sulfate in your shampoo and conditioner. That shouldn't be a thing. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna go for a new shampoo and conditioner. I'm not gonna get any sulfates. Like, it can't have any sulfates, any of that. So I was gonna get the Whey one, but then I smelled it and I was like, this is kind of actually making me want to gag. I saw this. This is the brand Day. And if you guys think that sounds familiar, if you've seen any Emily Kaiser videos or the Slickback Queens girlies on TikTok, a lot of them use the Day like hair gels to like help them slick back their hair. But this is from that same brand, and this is like one of their shampoo and conditioner. And so I decided to try it because it said there's no sulfates, there's none of those ingredients in it. Then I also picked up the Wow Extra Strength Dream Coat. This is that anti-frizz treatment that I think that you see like when it's like, oh my gosh, your hair looks so silky, luminous and straight, and it looks like a goddess. I did restock on these because I used the last absolute, like, I was taking the bottle of this and just like, oh, like as hard as I can, just squeezing it as hard as I can to even get any remnants of lotion out of it. Because I ran out of this one first, the Summer Fridays Summer Silk body lotion. I had ran out of this one, and then I ran out of this one today. I love this one for the winter. This is gonna sound so annoying. I've been using this one all winter because it's like that cocoa butter smell. And I use this one obviously all winter as well, but this one I'm really excited for the summer. the summertime. Then I stopped by Drunk Elephant, got scared of the 10-year-olds that I've been hearing about in Sephora, except I have had an encounter with one of them before, so it's not like this is like a fake thing on the internet. I needed to replenish my supply of moisturizer, and I use the purple one. I think it's the Lala Whipped Retro Cream. I don't know. I don't know what any of this stuff does, and I probably should know what I'm putting on my face. This one's new. This one's Bora Barrier Repair Cream. It's quite literally just the same thing, but orange is how I look at it. Also, something that I've been looking for is sunscreen that feels like putting on moisturizer, because the Super Goop I always use all throughout the summertime, but it has that feel, and listen, feely things to me. Like, I'm very weird about it. And it doesn't feel like putting on moisturizer. It feels like putting on just this, like, that's how I would describe the feeling of it. So I've been looking for one that I can put on, like, after moisturizer, under makeup, or just like moisturizer and then SPF. So I'm gonna try this one. This is the Umber Sheer Physical Daily Defense. It's SPF 30, and I really trust Drunk Elephant. Really hoping that this sunscreen will work. So I said that I was running low on body wash, and I've been using this one for a while now. This is the Isle of Paradise body wash. I go between this and Native, and like, I don't know, I randomly will just like go on Amazon and I will look up body wash and I will just buy one, or I'll like be on Sephora and I'll look up body wash and I'll just buy one. But this one, I absolutely am obsessed with the scent of it. It literally smells like summertime. It smells like I'm just like a beach babe. Smells like a surf when I put this on, so I love it. And I smelled the yellow one today and I was like, ooh, you're coming home with me. I like use so much body wash because, hey, I have said it so many times, I have a fear of smelling bad. I have a fear of smelling bad. So I will be in the shower and I just like wash my body, and I'll sit there and then I will wash my body again, and then I will wash my body again. It's, I mean, at least it's a good thing to be weird about. Then I picked up a new Summer Fridays cherry lip balm. Hopefully they work. Please let me know if you've ever tried it. This is the Faded Topicals Brightening and Clearing Serum. It says it is for what it does, balances, smooths, brightens, whatever. It says fade the look of your most stubborn marks, scars, and spots. The serum is packed with purposeful actives that let you kick back and let your worries fade away. So from what I understand, because I have done research into what to use on my face for my acne scarring, very bad acne scarring that I usually don't try to show, but it's been really bad lately. So this has shown up multiple times when I've done research. So I thought it was looking, I walked into Sephora and it was just sitting right there. It's not a new product. It was just sitting at the front, and then I looked at it and it looked at me and I was like, wow. Okay, this feels like a sign. That is my Sephora haul. That's like what I got from there. So yeah, it's around 2:30 right now. Let me see if my video's uploaded yet. No, it's still uploading. I need to send that over to Veronica. Veronica, I'm sorry. I am literally valiantly trying YouTube, and yeah, anyway. So I'm about to go on a run. Thankfully today is only a 2-mile run. Guess how it feels outside. It's like 56 degrees outside, which is super warm if you live in the Midwest. Anybody else may literally be like, girl, that is so cold. In Indiana, once we hit the high 50s, people are wearing shorts outside. I am people. I literally have been wearing this outfit all day, shorts and a sweatshirt. So it's only 2 miles, so I'm feeling good about that. So I'm about to do that. That's why I've been drinking on this. That's probably why I'm also talking 1,000 miles a minute. Holy crap. Here's the plan for the rest of the day. After that, I am probably going to pick up my room, and I'm giving myself a little bit of a brain break. I'm probably gonna listen to an audiobook to start my Can I Finish My TBR video. So I think I'm gonna start the audiobook of All the Light We Cannot See, or From Blood and Ash. I'm gonna also seek out the From Blood and Ash audiobook. So I'm technically going to be working on that video because I'm gonna be listening to that while I clean. And then I think I'm gonna honestly guys, I'm gonna be so real with you. I'm going to play Animal Crossing. Just needs to happen. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. But I'm about to go on this run, and let me tell you guys, I told you guys last week, hey, let's move. So I told you guys last week that I am going somewhere the kind of like tail end of March. I'm being secretive about it. It's honestly annoying. I don't know. It's just, I'm being secretive. And I was like, ooh, pair of walking shoes, and I bought some new Hokas. Don't know why. But these ones are the Clifton 9s. And these ones are actually the ones that people say to use for running. And I actually do not run in Clifton 9s. I don't know what I run in. I think they're the Bondis, which I have learned are absolutely not what you should really probably be using for running. So these are the Clifton 9s. I need to go downstairs and see what the ones I got for Christmas are, because I thought that those were Clifton 9s, but I know they're not because I know that they don't say Clifton 9 right here. I got this one because they have little colorful accents and they're gonna go with like all the outfits and stuff that I'm wearing. If you know anything, it's not ideal for me to just go and wear this shoe, like not broken, it's gonna cause me pain. So I was like, you know what, while I try to break these in, I'm just gonna start wearing these in my outdoor runs just to break them in before I go. But I think I'm gonna wear these today on my run, especially since it's only 2 miles. And you know what, it's about little things, because I know I'm very hard on myself, especially with the whole entire running thing. Honestly, if you would have looked at me even back in January, and it's only like, this is like the 20th of February, I never would have looked at 2 miles. I'm like, psh, easy, okay, 2 miles. Like, that is what I have to remind myself. I'm even looking at like 3 miles. It's like, okay, that's not bad. I can definitely do 3 miles. And in January, that probably would have put me into cardiac arrest. I would have been like, I cannot imagine running 3 miles. You will never see me running 3 miles. 2 miles is if I'm really feeling good that day. Like, I am not running 2 miles. Yes, I want to run a half marathon. I want to show myself that I can do it. But when, and this changed for me when I read Atomic Habits, because, you know, I was going to say it's annoying, but like, okay, self-help books help sometimes, but sometimes, most of the time, they're toxic. Atomic Habits kind of opened my eyes to this. Before I read it and I was going into my New Year's resolutions, I was like, I want to run a half marathon. I want to be able to run, blah, blah, blah. I read Atomic Habits, and in the book, it said, like, yeah, you have this goal, but why don't you make it to where, like, instead of saying, like, I want to work out 5 times a week, just be like, yeah, I want to be active. I want to be an active person, instead of, like, putting, like, a super specific goal. So instead of saying, I want to run a half marathon, turned it into, I want to become a runner. I swear that changed my mindset, because even I was thinking about this the other day, like, once I actually run a half marathon, I have actually gotten so used to running being a part of my routine that I'm like, you know what, do I need to run like the 10 miles a day? No, absolutely not. I'm not even doing that now. But I do still want to incorporate running. Like, right now I think I do like 4 runs a week, I think is what it is. I would like to still have that in my routine, let's not try to use a big word, of being like, yeah, like, especially when it's nice outside, and just incorporate that to get some extra cardio in. Myself becoming a runner, not like a super long distance runner, but it is something that I like pushing myself to do. I look forward to myself to keep on going and seeing where I am mentally in this mindset. So yeah, I'm about to run, and I'm about to test out these Clifton 9s. I actually honestly might ask my mom if she wants to walk afterwards. Checking in with you guys, it is about 6 o'clock, and I surprisingly did everything that I thought, because earlier when I was like, yeah, I'm gonna like clean my room and take a shower, and I thought in my head, I was like, I'm probably not gonna put away my laundry or do any of that. I'm talking about maybe just like put up the stuff that I bought earlier, put up books, all of that stuff. But I surprisingly put all my laundry away, didn't make my bed, because I'm literally about to spend the rest of the day in my bed, so I would have just made my bed to unmake it, so I didn't. But it probably doesn't look super clean right now. Honestly, it probably doesn't look very, very different. It is a little bit cleaner. And I put up my books. I did all of that. I also blow dried my hair, which I was surprised I did. Tried out that Wow stuff. And I don't know. I mean, I feel like, yeah, like it is like less frizzy because I didn't take the time to like super blow dry it. But I also feel like it's not giving that illusion that it says. I don't know. The rest of the night, I honestly am just going to not even speak to a single person and just sit on my bed. And I know that you guys are probably like, Destiny, that kind of sounds like something you shouldn't do. Listen, I kind of feel like I just need the time to sit by myself. Like, I just need time alone and just to, I'm honestly gonna play Animal Crossing. I'm probably gonna listen to an audiobook, maybe, maybe not, and just go in, and I'm just going to sit and listen to Animal Crossing. I'm going to play Animal Crossing because I'm going to be busy for literally like the rest of the week, and I just really feel like I need some time to decompress, not worry about vlogging. I'm not worrying about like having to inherently like film a video. So that's what my plan is for the rest of the night. It's only 6 o'clock, so I plan on just chilling. Am I sweating? No, for once. Okay. Hey guys, it is, what is today? Wednesday. Okay. It is around, like, I think it's almost 1 o'clock. Did the usual today. Woke up, went to the gym. We know. Hey girl, we know. I came home and I filmed some stuff that you may or may not, well, you may not, or you may see soon. I'm not going to say anything, but it was just like a get ready with me type style video. And when I woke up today, I was like, okay, today I'm gonna go get my nails done. These nails are pretty, but I have hated them ever since I've had them. Anyway, so I was like, I wanna get my nails done today because I don't wanna get them done tomorrow. We're filming the podcast later. So I told myself that if I came home, filmed my little like get ready with me video, and then I just posted my new releases that I read, I was like, okay, get your nails done and then come home, film the pod, edit the pod later, and then tomorrow, like, you don't have to worry about like going out and doing it. I'm trying to force myself right now to go get my nails done. I'm gonna have to get a whole entire new set because I want to get almond shape, and we can't turn these into almond. We can't. Gonna do it. Also, I've been testing out, my brother got me this Polaroid for my birthday that we've chatted about it before, me and him, like a big Polaroids. I said how I love my little Polaroids and I want like the big like vintage feel Polaroids. So I've been testing them out. This one was weird. This one like did this, but it gives you that old school feel. Literally both of the pictures are just of my dog. I'm gonna start reading books as well today for my Can I Finish My TBR, because this is my TBR for the month. Have not even started any of the books, but I just went on Audible and I bought 5 new credits. And I just bought All the Light We Cannot See. I may get From Blood and Ash as well and listen to those. May even get City of Girls. I've been in my audiobook era because I listen to them while I'm doing everything. I listen to them while I'm on the treadmill. I listen while I'm cleaning. I listen to them while I'm just like sitting in bed and like don't feel like doing anything. I just put on an audiobook. I might get those 3 audiobooks and then like physically read the rest of these books. Just put on my Apple Watch. I'm gonna grab my stuff and I'm gonna head out. Okay guys, I just got done with my nails. This is what they look like. They're a sleigh. I'm literally in love with them. She did such a good job and I love how dainty they feel. I'm at Smoothie King, about to order a smoothie, hold on. Can I just do your Gladiator strawberry, double strawberry, please? Oh, thank you. Always like really get scared to go get my nails done, or not scared, like very anxious to go get my nails done, and I'm like, oof, I do not want to do it. I was listening to All the Light We Cannot See while I was getting my nails done, and I was like so engrossed in the story, like I was literally like there. I was listening to it, and that's what I love about audiobooks. And that's where the people who are like, me, audiobooks are not reading, you need to get a life. You need to get a life and mind your business, because I am so much more in the story. Like, I am, like, just there. I'm, like, just someone on the sidewalk watching this story go by than when I read them. And that's why I've been loving listening to audiobooks. I just always feel so much better, like, when I go get my nails done and then they're done and I'm, like, whew, I feel a lot better. But now I'm sweating. Really hoping that I'm not going to have to pee my pants. I'm going to put you guys down here because you guys know that I can't film. Good morning. I feel like I am literally running late for school. It is 6:54. Usually I have been like getting out the door the past like week or so, like 6:20. I woke up this morning because I heard my brother leaving for work, and he leaves after I do, and I was like and I literally feel like I'm late for school. Like I feel like I'm like okay, I need to fill up my water bottle. I'm like out of my Alani's. There, that's why the sliding was so bad. Out Stanley, just my going out Stanley. Okay. Going to the gym. Today is shoulders and chest day. Triceps if I'm lucky. I already hit triceps earlier this week, but I love always hitting triceps. So if I'm lucky and can get to the machinery that I use for my tricep workouts, then we're lucky. Also, just a moment for the nails. I love them. She went around showing everybody her shoes on. She was like, look at them. Look at them. They're so cute. I was like, they are. Okay, I have a busy day today. I can't really chat with you guys in the car. Staying alive. Y'all, it literally feels like a summer day outside. It is not cold at all. Oh, I love that weather. I love when it's just warm and rainy. I saw this TikTok and it was like Midwesterners when it hits 50 degrees. And I was like, it was just TikTok. But it was so freaking true. My depression, I got scared by myself in the mirror. Like I thought it was like in a scary movie when all of a sudden you looked behind you. Hold on. That's a terrifying thought. Hey, why would I even tell myself that? Okay, it is 7 a.m. What do I want to listen to? Let's hop into last year's spring playlist. And you guys may be like, oh, so you have a spring playlist. Like, you're not going to make another one? Yes, I am. I actually made this one. This is such a fun fact. If you go on my Spotify and you see spring is nearing, skin is clearing, the playlist, which I hope that's true this year. Hope that's true. Hope skin starts clearing. I made this when I was in Jersey with Haley and Sarah for the first time. Y'all, that is about to be a year next month. I like almost can't take that. I can't believe that I haven't known them all my life. Isn't that crazy? That's what it feels like though. It feels like I have known them all my life. So, okay, I need to get to the gym. But first I'll run you guys through my day. That way you guys just know. So thank God. I already edited the pod. Like, everything is ready to go. Well, I have to make the thumbnail and do some other, like, little tiny things, like timestamping it and everything. But it's all ready to go. Like, I don't have to worry about the day. Usually, when I get back, I'm always, like, still worrying about the podcast. I don't have to do that today. Go listen to the pod if you haven't yet. So, I don't have to worry about that. So, my plan is that you guys have already seen the video. My hot take video I'm going to film today. So I think that I'm gonna stop by Dunkin' on the way home. I'm gonna pick up a coffee, and then it's just gonna kind of be a like sit down chit chatty style super like laid back video. So I need to get that sent over today because it does have like a brand deal attached to it. But I'm gonna come home and I'm gonna film that. And then after I film it, since I'm going to be editing it today, I'm going to take a break. So I'm going to go to the grocery store, and then I'm going to go for my run. And then after that is done, I'm going to just spend the rest of the day editing. And then I'm going to start reading for my Can I Finish My TBR video. Okay, my goal is I would love, like in a perfect world, I would love if I could get finished with my TBR before like the week is over. Obviously I would love if I could like spend the weekend and stuff like really trying to knock out my TBR, because obviously I'm doing my reset video. I want that video up before the month is over. I'm doing my March TBR. like, we got a lot of stuff going on up here, y'all. Little unhinged. Let's see what song is the first. It was Dear John. Sorry, I can't do that this morning. Hey, can't do that this morning. I'm back from the gym. I'm about to touch up my hair. It's like when I straighten it, it gets a little wonky. Took a shower, I'm back from the gym. I'm about to film the Unpopular Opinions video, so I'm about to go grab a coffee. I feel like I've been spending an excessive amount of time on Pinterest and on all of the things that I see, all these girls drinking out of these cute ceramic mugs. Also watching Bestie Rachel's vlogs, she always has like really cute ceramic mugs, and I love mugs, but I don't drink like tea, and I don't drink like hot drinks that you like use mugs for. I get like so sad because I'm like, I really want some cute ceramic mugs, but like what would I use them for? Like, you don't even drink hot drinks, so they would just sit there. Like, what are you gonna do, put an iced coffee in it? I mean, I'm sure I could if it really like push came to shove, but I'm not gonna do that, you know? I had every intention of putting on makeup today, but I just don't feel like it. And you know what? I don't need to. You know what? I don't need to. But should I? Did that kind of make them? I guess it did. I guess it made it a little bit better. Okay, I'm excessively sweating and that's really annoying. I do not feel like putting on makeup, especially because I have to run later. Like, I don't want to put any on and I don't have to. A little bit of an update. It is a little bit later. It's around like noonish now. And of course, right when I'm about to get out for the day, it decides to start raining. It's raining hard right now, but I'm about to go out and run a few errands. I have a few like little fun errands that I want to do. I'm going to stop by Best Buy, stuff like that. I know I said that I was going to go grocery shopping today, but I just realized that my mom is cooking dinner tonight, so I don't need to like go get anything for dinner. And also, I'm literally going down to see Isaac this weekend, as I do all weekends, so it's kind of pointless for me to go grocery shop when I'm literally gonna be gone all weekend, and I usually grocery shop on Sundays/Monday anyway. So I'm not gonna go grocery shopping. I'm just gonna get out of the house for a bit today. I think I'm gonna go to Best Buy because I have my eye on a new vlog camera that I've been thinking about for a few months now. So I'm kind of thinking about it, and I just kind of wanted to go like see it, think about it some more. So that's what we're doing. Me. It's about 4 p.m. and I just got back from my run, took another shower, so here we are. Now I just kind of get to chill, if you will. To recap earlier, I went by Best Buy and I checked out. They had the camera and the lens that I wanted and they didn't have it in stock. I think I'm just gonna like think about it, even though I really, really wanna buy it right now. I'm just going to kind of sit and think about it. I did get some packages though. I made an order at Wildflower the other day because I like love these. So wait, these are my AirPods cases. I just got clear cases from Amazon, like threw some Spider-Man stickers on there. Oh, putting on these cases suck. Basically, I got inspired because I saw a very aesthetic person on my Pinterest with like AirPods cases on that had like actual patterns on them. So I know that Wildflower has some, so I bought this one. I think I'm gonna put these on like when it's the summertime. That's okay. It's like summer berries pattern. If you've seen like Jerf Avenue, like the robe basically kind of has that same print on it. And I think that these are so cute and I love them for many reasons. First of all, because I was really into precious moments as a kid, and this reminds me of all of my precious moments things that I had. They're like little lambs and they are so freaking cute. Put these on. Oh my god, these look like they're way easier to put on too. Oh, bless. Oh my god. Okay, these are so cute. Literally, shut up. I want you guys to stop talking. Look at that. They're so cute. These are so cute. Now I want to like wear these while I edit, even though I never wear headphones while I edit. But yeah, but also I signed up for the Eternal Embers box. And honestly, I'm going to cancel my Illumicrate subscription. I've gotten like two of those boxes and I just like don't love them. I've actually seen this on Instagram somewhere, like somebody posted it and I was like, oh, I want those so bad because I love the Bad Reputation duet so much by Chris and Becca Ritchie. It's like you read the Addicted Calloway Sister series and then you read the Bad Reputation duet because it's about like other characters that you meet in the background, so you get to like actually read their story. And nobody talks about the Bad Reputation duet and nobody talks about the couple in it, and I love them so much. Like, I'm obsessed with it. So somebody had posted like this and then they posted these books and I was like, oh, like I didn't really pay any attention to where they were from, but this is the little, like if you've read them you understand why they look like, they look like the comic books. And then like this is the back of them. They're everything. Oh my god, I love them. I love them. If you guys have read the Addicted Calloway Sister series and haven't read the Bad Reputation duet, what are you doing? This is from Eternal Embers, which I think they have like, I think it's like a subscription box. I honestly don't know how it works because I just signed up for it and then they gave me this and then these. Those are my little unboxing moments. I'm about to put up laundry, start editing, you know, stuff that you guys see me do all of the freaking time. It's 6 a.m. and I did not want to get up this morning. I'm looking at my Apple Watch. I'm thinking this, but yesterday I forgot my Apple Watch. No, I didn't. It was dead. So like I forgot, but I didn't even put it on the charger. So I didn't wear it to the gym, and then when I went on my run, I didn't wear it either. And usually I wear my Apple Watch like all day, every day, take it off to go to bed. And I literally felt like my workout yesterday that I did, like my whole entire workout and my running, I felt like I didn't even work out because I wasn't wearing my Apple Watch. 19, but you act 25 now. And me and UMG have beef. Well, I already talked about how we kind of have beef on the pod. Not like we have beef on the pod, but I talked about this on the pod with UMG because they obviously took the music off of TikTok, and that is really annoying me. If you guys want to hear me do a whole rant on that, it's on the pod. My rant with him today is that the video that I worked on yesterday and got uploaded last night, and I woke up this morning and I went to the bathroom and I was literally about to send the link to my manager to be like, here's the video. They literally copyrighted it. And I put like 5 seconds of a song. Basically, I had like just a few words of the song in here. Boom, copyrighted me. Oh, okay. So now I'm re-uploading it and sending it to her, but it's just, I'm annoyed today by that. I'm annoyed. I think it's like super foggy right now outside, so there's literal delays. I'm getting back to my like old water intake, and by that I mean like for the past like 2 or 3 days I've been drinking like over 120 ounces of water. And you know what? It happened the second I brought the big Stanley back in my life. My gym outfit, I'm trying to give spring. See how it's like green. OMG. This is my last Alani. I don't have any more. Today, I'll tell you that. Don't even want to have a little snippet of it. UMG's gonna copyright me because they own literally everything somehow. I literally don't know. Oh, I guess it's United Music Group. So I guess Anyway, I just got done with my workout. I was there for about over an hour and a half. I've started to develop that on the days that I'm not running. So Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Those are like my not running days because I run Tuesdays, Thursdays, Saturday, and Sunday. Some Saturdays I don't run. If there's gonna be like a super long run on Sundays, I don't run on Saturday because you don't wanna like overexert yourself. So basically, I have decided, this is like a new thing that I've just started to do kind of like this week, started it last week, but really been doing it this week, is that the days I don't have to run, I basically try to walk at like a 3.5, it's like a fast walk speed on the treadmill for an hour, and I walk over 3 miles. So I try to do that on the days that I'm not running. That way you're still getting like pretty much like a lot of miles in, and it's just really like getting your body moving. And I feel like that's kind of my like no brain power time, or like my time to kind of get my thoughts together in the morning. And I really like it because it's the time on the treadmill, like spending an hour and just walking, like you're not having to worry about running, not having to worry about anything. I don't allow myself to go on social media. I do get on Pinterest, but I've said I don't count that as socials, but basically I just kind of use it as the time to think about my day. I think I go on Pinterest, I watch like some YouTube videos that I just kind of want to sit and catch up on. I started to do my runs, and I started to really like how those are kind of set up of like throughout the week. It's like 2 to 3 miles. Doesn't ever really exceed that because it's like kind of regular, and then on the weekends they may get like a little bit longer because I just don't feel like I'd ever see myself as somebody that just like, you know, like runs 6 miles every day. Like I think that 2 to 3 miles, if I was feeling good, 4 mile run at least 3 times a week is like super good, and then longer distances on the weekend. I feel like I'm genuinely starting to see the goal that I had of like just turning into like a runner. Feeling great about that. I'm about to go home and make breakfast, and I'm gonna get the thumbnail going for the video that I sent over today, and I think I'm going to try to sit down and read a book. I honestly think I'm gonna end the vlog right here. Wow, me actually ending a vlog for once, who am I? But it's just that I'm going to be like working on other things when I get home, and there's nothing else to really vlog today. That's the end of this weekly vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed. I feel like it was kind of not like eventful, but I feel like some different things were whatever. I don't know. Maybe it sucks. Maybe you guys are like, no, Dusty, this was terrible. I'm sorry. I'll pick back up the camera on Sunday to take you guys along with my day, as I do. I mostly start these videos either on Sunday or Monday. So I'll see you guys next week on Sunday, but it'll technically be my last week's Sunday. This is kind of getting way too confusing for me. Okay, I'm also going to try to edit this vlog today after I finish a book. So, love you guys so much. Thank you for continuously tuning into my vlogs and telling me that you like them, because it is extremely validating for me, even though I still think that they suck and everybody hates them. But I do appreciate all of your guys' kind words, and they mean the absolute world to me. And I love you guys so much, and I appreciate you. And you guys literally mean the world to me. Okay, love you. Bye.